One of the biggest worries for teachers is dealing with the behaviour of students. What happens if a student accesses a website or social media whilst they are in the lesson? These types of things need school rules, classroom rules, and teacher expectations. For example, it's no good the teacher telling the students to share their ideas on social media if the school rules don't allow students to use the social media. It's a good idea to get some student ground rules with the students together. If you are using devices with different age groups, you might find it helpful to have a student group or student council meeting to do this. One of the phrases that schools often use with students is that the tablets should be used for learning. If students are not using the devices for learning, then that will be breaking the rules. One of the other challenges for teachers is the layout of the classroom, and not every classroom can be changed, but equally, using tablets in rows won't explore the full potential of these mobile devices. One of the best ways to do this is to ask the students to use the devices in a space outside the classroom, a visit to a local interest space, a walk in a nearby park. However, at some point, you will be back in your classroom for your lessons, and this is where the CCL scenario planning process can help you think about the layout of your room. This will be explained more in Module 2. If you tried the scenario on collaboration, you have to think about how the students can work together. For some teachers, it can be more complex if you have to move rooms or different groups of students across the timetable of the day. And if this is the case, you may find it is helpful to identify particular learning spaces in school which can be adapted for using the tablets. This is where a pilot implementation programme can really help, because you can give the students different classroom layouts and see how they like to work best by asking them for their feedback. One of the other areas that teachers often notice when using tablets with students is that their own position in the class changes. This is particularly the case where teachers have got into the habit of standing at the front, delivering the content with a didactic approach. The introduction of tablets can suddenly leave the teacher thinking that the students are all engaged in their task and busy. And the teacher thinks it's enough just to walk around the room and see the students working or researching information. This is where it's absolutely crucial that the tasks that the student have been asked to do are appropriate to their learning outcomes, and formative assessment of the individual student progress is taking place. Otherwise, the teacher can end up with very little evidence at the end of the lesson. The scenario development process that we adopt during the Creative Classrooms Lab project helps the teacher to identify the outputs for the different phases. For example, if the ultimate goal of the scenario is to produce a video, there are many different phases along the way: dream, map, explore, and each one of these should involve different tasks which require individual student outputs and assessment. Storyboarding, role play, learning about the context, it might be set in a particular place or period of history. It's not just about the video. It therefore becomes the teacher's role to plan an overview of the tasks and guide the students through the different phases. As you become more confident, one of the things that a number of the CCL teachers have identified is the independence of the students, and this means that you can begin to let them make some decisions about which apps they choose to create particular lesson outputs, and indeed let them decide about what they will create. The big worry for most teachers is the examination. If they use the tablet, will they still pass their tests? Of course, there is no definitive answer to this. What CCL teachers have realised is that taking time to plan for the use of tablets, identifying the most relevant areas of the school curriculum, and integrating the tablets alongside other resources is an ongoing process. It really is about finding out what works best with your students and trying different approaches. Finally, I have one last, perhaps slightly unusual request. At present, we have educationalists from countries all over the world joining in with this MOOC. I'd love to receive a traditional postcard from you in your country to add to my collection from the different places I've been and to hear about how you're getting on with the implementation of tablets. You can write to me at the address on screen.